Hello, e-commerce entrepreneurs. I'm Veronica Wasik, founder of Mavency, where we help Shopify sellers and their bookkeepers to set up, organize, and streamline their financial systems and bookkeeping. In this video, I'll show you my three-step method for recording Shopify sales and fees in QuickBooks Online without using an app. I'm really excited to show you my three-step process for recording Shopify income and fees in QuickBooks Online. So what is the three-step process? Well, number one, we will record Shopify income. Number two, record payment processor fees. And number three, categorize deposits from payment processors. Here are some things that you need to keep in mind. This may not be the right fit for you. So this process is really based on entering summarized monthly transactions into QuickBooks using journal entries, and you will not be using an integrator app. This is a good fit for either small sellers or maybe you're just getting started and not ready to commit to an app yet. If you're using a few payment processors or if you're only using Shopify payments. There are some limitations to this way of recording transactions in QuickBooks. Because of the timing differences between Shopify and whenever it processes sales and when it processes payouts, there will be some differences that we will have to record to a clearing account, and I will explain that in a little bit. Before we get started, we have to do a little bit of setup in QuickBooks in order to set up the account categories that we will need. We're going to add accounts to the QuickBooks Online chart of accounts. So you'll need to download the free Shopify bookkeeping blueprint. I have linked that for you in the description. It's going to give you the account categories that you will need to add to the chart of accounts as indicated in that blueprint. And these are the account categories that you will need to use to customize your chart of accounts that will be specific to Shopify. So your QuickBooks chart of accounts will not have these accounts and these categories until you add them. Now let's do a demonstration of how to add the Shopify clearing account in QuickBooks Online. From the left, go to Accounting, Chart of Accounts. You'll see that we already added some of the accounts that I mentioned in the Shopify bookkeeping blueprint. To add a new account, go to the upper right, select New, select Assets. For Save Account Under, select Other Current Assets. For Tax Form section, select Other Current Assets. For the account name, we'll use Shopify Clearing, and then select Save. And here's the account that we just added together. All right, so now you're ready to get started. Let's start with the first step. We're going to record Shopify income using a journal entry. You'll need to go to Shopify to find the Shopify Finances Summary. Go to Shopify, Analytics, Reports, and then select Summary. Next, you'll need to change the date. In this case, I'm changing it to last month, and then click Apply. Then you'll see the Finances Summary in Shopify. On the left, you'll see Sales, Liabilities, and then on the right, you'll see Payments, which are the payouts. And you'll notice that I coded each one of these. You'll see what this means in a moment. Next, we'll need to make the journal entry in QuickBooks Online. Go to QuickBooks Online, click the plus new button, then select journal entry. You'll need to change the journal date, the journal number, and then we have accounts, debits, credits, and description. Okay, so let's make sense of this journal entry. Notice that I said I had coded each of the transactions that we will be using from the finances summary. So as you can see here, we have gross sales. That's coded as number one. There's our amount. And then going to the journal entry in QuickBooks, we will pick up the amount for gross sales. We'll categorize it to Shopify sales, enter the amount under the credits column. And notice that in the description, I put gross sales, meaning that's what we're using in the finances summary, and then I put whether it's a debit or a credit, or whether it goes under the debits column or the credits column. In this case, it goes under the credits column. And notice that we have some amounts here that are negative, like discounts and returns. So I pick those up, they go under the debit column. It's telling you discounts and returns go under debits. They're categorized to Shopify discounts and Shopify returns. And again, we already set up all of these account categories earlier when we used the Shopify bookkeeping blueprint. So I put those amounts under debit, but notice that they are not negative. So we don't want to enter any negative signs in any of these amounts. Then we have shipping income. So it's coming here. We have shipping income. There's our amount, $9,077.25. And as you can see, I told you that it goes under credits. So you will continue to enter all of the transactions just as I indicated here and enter those in the journal entry. So for example, let's take a look at payments. We have the manual gateway. So these are amounts that go through what we call clearing accounts. And we have the manual clearing account, and we're categorizing the amounts under debits to that account category. Next, we have PayPal payment standard, categorizing that to Shopify PayPal clearing as a debit. Then we have Shop Pay installments, number 9, and we categorize that to the Shop Pay Affirm clearing account. And then Shopify payments clearing is what was processed through Shopify payments. For the payments, you will need to make sure that you have set up clearing accounts for each of your payment processors. And those instructions are given to you in the Shopify bookkeeping blueprint. All right, now notice that total sales, $52,361, do not equal total payments. Total payments are $52,411. The reason that they are different is because of timing differences. So after you go through and enter everything as indicated, you will likely have a difference. And the differences are entered to Shopify clearing. And remember, we entered this account together earlier and set it up in the chart of accounts in QuickBooks. So that will be your difference. QuickBooks actually will auto-calculate that difference for you. And at the end, the total debits and the total credits must equal. When you're done, select Save and Close. All right, ready for step 2. We're going to record payment processor fees. So here's what you need to know. Amounts deposited from payment processors are net of fees. Payment processor fees need to be recorded. If they're not recorded, then your payment processor clearing accounts will not balance, and then you'll also be missing out on some tax deductions because your payment processor fees will not be recorded. And we'll need to run some reports to get the fees that we need for our entries. We're going to download the Shopify payouts report and get the fees. From Shopify, go to Finances, select Payouts. From the upper right, select Transactions, and then select Export. I will select the month of June since that's the month that we're working on. Export as a CSV for Excel and select Export Items. The report will be delivered to your email address, so make sure that you go to your email and grab that report. From the email you receive, click to download the file. Find the column that shows the fees and then scroll to the bottom of the report. Then add a formula to add up all of the fees, and this is the amount that you will need to record the fees in QuickBooks Online. Now we're going to make the journal entry in QuickBooks. Go to the plus new button, select journal entry, enter the journal entry date, which is normally the end of the month for which you're recording the fees. For your journal numbers, use Shopify fees. And then for the first row, we're going to use the account category of Shopify fees. We will debit the fee for the amount that we got from the payouts report, which I just showed you. And then we're going to enter another line for Shopify payments clearing, and we will put that in the credits column. Now in the description, I've given you a couple of little cheat sheets again. So the first line will be Shopify fees, that will be a debit. And then the next line is Shopify payments clearing, that is a credit. Now let's go over recording Amazon Pay fees. From Amazon, you'll need to find the report of fees and then find the expenses. So this is the amount of the fees. And again, we'll make the journal entry in QuickBooks, go to journal entry in QuickBooks Online. And now we're going to debit the Amazon fees for the amount that was on the report, and then we will credit Shopify Amazon clearing for the same amount. So I know that this can be a little bit confusing with the debits and the credits, so here are some tips to help you. For payment processor fees, we're going to debit or put amounts in the debits column for the expense. And we're going to use an account that corresponds to the payment processor expense that we're using. So whether it's Shopify payment fees, Amazon Pay fees, Affirm fees, whatever kind of fees that you have. And for the credits column, we're going to use the corresponding payment processor clearing account. So whether that is Shopify payments clearing, Shopify Amazon clearing, or Affirm clearing. So debits are expenses, credits are the payment processor clearing accounts. Now it's time for step three, categorizing deposits from payment processors. We're going to go to the QuickBooks banking transactions. So in QuickBooks, from the left, go to banking and select banking, and then find the bank account that receives all of the deposits from your payment processors. Look for the deposits from Shopify. They may say Shopify, sometimes they don't, so you'll need to know which deposits they are, but that will show up in the description in the bank feeds. And then for the category or match, you'll need to change the account category to Shopify Payments Clearing. Now, this is the example for categorizing deposits from Shopify Payments Clearing. Okay, so for any deposits from Shopify, then we're going to categorize those to Shopify Payments Clearing. And then go to the right and click add, and that will add those transactions to QuickBooks and categorize them properly without duplicating income. For other payment processors, in this example, we have ShopPay Affirm. You will record those to the Shopify ShopPay Affirm clearing account. And if you're using Afterpay, for example, you will categorize them to the Afterpay clearing account. And again, add them in QuickBooks, and that will get those transactions into your QuickBooks. All right, so there you have it. That was my three-step process for recording Shopify income and fees into QuickBooks. The first step was to record Shopify income. The second step was to record payment processor fees. And the third step was to categorize deposits received from payment processors. For more resources on Shopify bookkeeping and financial management, check out my free Shopify bookkeeping blueprint. I've linked that for you in the description. Are you ready to work with a trusted and reliable team of Shopify bookkeeping pros? Then check the description below to learn more about Mavency and whether we'd be a good fit for working together. Thanks for joining me today. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay updated with all things e-commerce bookkeeping. Till next time, happy selling!